broadcast. Let's.
There I am. All right. Boy, my gray is showing today, aren't I? Hold on one second. I think that's all I need. Let me see here. Well, I am determined to do this thing by myself since nobody is here. I just thought at least one of my team would have offered to help me here. So if somebody wants
Dr.
to... Yes, are you? Can you hear me? Yes, I can hear you. Can you?
I lost the connection, but you're light.
Okay, I was wondering what happened to you there. I'm going to, hello, God bless. Dr. Mike, how are you this morning? Extremely good. Hello, sweet Deborah. Ah, my sister's on. I just got off the phone with her. I didn't know you was going to be able to. I know Jason is good at Periscope, but he's in love, and he doesn't have time for his daddy much. Let's see here. Hold on. Family, just bear with me. I'll make it worth it here. I'm trying to set up my Periscope on my Pro. All right. Well, I tell you what. I'll just do it this way. By the way, thank you for all these messages. I'll come back and read them. John Lancer. Pastor Charlene, Lynn, Miss Rita, Christian White. Christian, that's Bobby's son. Son, I do remember you. I do remember your name now. I remember that your daddy, I can't believe he's gone on to be with the Lord. Well, let me tell you what's on my mind. Let me get my Snapple here. You that are following on the phone, I sure hope that... you understand I'm on Periscope simultaneously, and I've got two little things working here for me. All right. Who said I can't stop listening to you? I've been looking for you my whole life. I tell you what's in my mind today. This 20% increase in your finances. I'm beginning to come and, this hatred of prosperity ministry is demonic. Even sane people know the value of money. Even sane people know the value of money. We're going to talk about 20% increase today, and I'm going to come back after this and read all your notes. I won't be able to focus and notice, but I love your notes. Hello, Tony. Good to see you online. Hadn't seen you in 39 years. Christian, your daddy was one of the greatest joys in my life. I spent more time with him and never regretted one minute. Never regretted one minute with your father. He brought me more joy. He had a deep sincerity. And he taught me how to relax. Somebody just got 20 books in the mail yesterday, 31 Days of Wisdom, etc. And by the way, let me go ahead and go. Pastor Isaiah, if I keep reading your, I'll never get around to teaching here because you're so sharp. What's CIA, Church in Action? I love that, CIA. I love that. Oh, Lindy McCauley. Oh, I miss you. One of the greatest experiences, one of the most beautiful, poised ladies of, lady of elegance. You carried so much royalty, everybody's uncomfortable around you. That's the, Pastor McGinnis, I'm coming to New York to be with you. I will do it as soon as I can. I will. I love you, Lindy, very, very much. Very, very much. Annette, thank you. From Dubai, oh, I've got to contact you because I love Dubai. It changed the whole way I see things. Had a real bad scenario last night here in the neighbors. With the neighbors, one man got out in the middle of the road and stopped my staff. about 10:30, 11 o'clock last night. I had to call police and things, etc. I'll tell you more about it later. But let me tell you what's really on my heart today. Money is a glorious, glorious thing. There it is. Okay. Money is more glorious asset as an asset when you know what to do with it. It's kind of like a hammer. A child has a hammer, and the child doesn't know what to do and with it. But when taught, the hammer can build, etc. I don't know any downside to prosperity. Some people forget God, but then some people are poor and forget God. So I never think it's the prosperity that makes me forget God, or it hasn't me, maybe some people. There is a warning about that. There's a warning that you get so preoccupied with the gifts of God that you forget Him. But I have, here somebody says, I'm a womanizer. Ah, well, where are they? Where are they? I sure do love women. I sure do love women, and I'm not sexually attracted to men, my dear apostle or whoever you are. I wouldn't call you an apostle if you say that. I just saw something bad on there. I'll have to remember that, yeah, haters are going to hate. The insane must be insane. They got to be. I just saw something on there. My philosophy is that the Word of God teaches. In fact, this is why I'm opening up Protégé 1000. You can write me right now at Protégé 7, I think it is, Protégé 7 at thewisdomcenter.tv. My thoughts on finances is that because I was raised poor and I was raised, we didn't have anything. My daddy couldn't send me to Bible college and it was $4 a day. I really, really I'm trying to see where my phone is. Here we are. Miss Pretty, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. That helps me. Someone here says, I hate poverty. It is a curse. And my precious lady, you are so right. I have a hatred of it too. I have a hatred too. I have a hatred of poverty. I hate when I drive through ghettos and I want to get out and say, let's start with cleaning up everything around here. Let's start with order. And I can't hardly say that because I'm in the middle of moving in this house. It don't look very orderly to me today. I'm going to work with 20% increase in finances, okay? I would like for you to double, and I feel like I could. If you're making $40,000, I think in 12 months I could get you to $80,000. But we're going to work with 20% income increase, okay? That's the stirring of my heart. And by the way, I just wet down my hair. You that are watching me, I just wet down my hair because I wake up and it's about 5 inches high in the air and all that. Let me focus here. Let me try to get focused. I can't think of anything bad about having money. A good man with money is a good experience. A good man with money is a good experience. He can bless people, bless his family, he can encourage. And I feel that the Bible teaches that money is a result of obedience to God's word. You say, well, if that was the case, why don't people who intercede have any money? Why don't all the preachers, why don't all the missionaries have money? My experience with missionaries, and I've had much experience with missionaries, is they really don't believe in prosperity, generally speaking. I would say 9 out of 10 missionaries that I know do not believe in prosperity. I've been stopped on the road by them in Africa. I've been harassed by them. I've been criticized. I've gotten in arguments. From the time I was 26 years old, went to Nairobi Christian Center, where Wanatimbo, that's the word in Swahili for Lord Elephant. Morris Plotts is one of the greatest men I ever knew in my lifetime. There's nobody like him, a master speaker. He could make, I travel with him. And his grandson married one of my nieces. But he brought me to Africa. He asked me to open up the Nairobi Christian Center many years ago. I guess that was 40. I can't believe it was over 40. It's like yesterday to me, 40 years. But the missionaries there, Dale Kingsrider, his beautiful wife, Marlis, Dale was very angry at me teaching prosperity to the people there at the Nairobi Christian Center. Dale was a fabulous man, a good man, a strong man. But he had a twist in his philosophy. Many people do. And I'm having to hold this. By the way, I'm using an iPad Pro today instead of my phone for my Periscope. Someone said, "We love you, Dr. Mike." I'm going to have to come back. P-A-Z, pause. I'm going to come back and read all these and find out how I can... No, I have no plans to go to Hawaii. Somebody do. Hello, Barbara from Las Vegas. Barbara, I love you. Thank God for you. Christian, my dad said you're a very generous man. Well, that's the purpose of money, Christian. That's the purpose of money. I have a problem with it, though. I give away more than I keep for myself. And that's not too smart. But I don't give away just because I'm generous. I just have a love for people. And I love to sow. I just love to sow. I don't want to die with any money in the bank. That would be a waste to me. Unless in other words, I'm the one that knows what to do with my money. If I leave it to somebody, they're not going to know what to do with it, what I would do with it. I don't keep as much money as I really should, probably, because money's for movement. What I love about being with you today at 1 o'clock is I'm going to be able to tell you some of my philosophy, and if it resonates with you, resonate meaning if it makes sense to you. I'm a man who really likes logic, and that's kind of another flip side of generosity, but I like logic. I believe that money is to do good. I believe that money is an active tool. Like a hammer or a saw or your car. I don't save a lot of money. We should, because the Bible tells us to. Go to the ant, thou sluggard. Observe her ways, how in the summer she prepares for winter. Let's go back to my subject of 20% increase. You got to think increase. You got to think increase. You got to think about multiplication. If you're interested in increasing 20% this year, you must increase your productivity. The Bible said God will reward every man according to his work. That means that fruit is a result of taking care of a tree. I feel like if I solve problems, God himself will bless me. God himself will bless me. I'm very spontaneous. I was using an illustration in Brazil one time and was saying, I have everybody to write down their top 10 dreams and goals for their life. Almost every time I go to a city or go to a meeting, I will do it April the 29th on Friday night when I go to London, England. I will do it Sunday morning in Lagos, May the 1st and 2nd, Sunday and Monday. I will do that. I will have everybody take out a sheet of paper and write down a list of their dreams and goals. Sis, if you're watching me not right now or listening, remember the 31 Days of Wisdom. There are several things I want to put in my international seed book. And by the way, I'm going to tell everybody, I put out an international seed book where I take 31 topics that are very important to people and give them wisdom keys on those topics. I give away a book because it's something they can keep in their hand. Very few books are usable in the moment, but mine are. I really feel like my books are made for succeeding right now. My books are not ambiguous. I'm a very simple man. I do not consider myself a smart man unless I get around some non-listeners and some people that don't learn. Then I think I'm real smart next to some folks. What makes me, I'm a learner, and you must become a learner. Let me give you the, I'm just going to look out here. I'm not going to read your, I'll come back and read your comments later if you don't mind. Oh, thank you, Lucy. Somebody said, I love my ebook. I had 30 left, 30 book. Now, we'll order more, but right now, ready to send out to you. Anyone that plants a $300 seed during the month of April, I will get you an ebook reader with 501 of my best books. It's a deal and a half. The $300 is a seed to help me stay on television. The Word TV Network costs me about $40,000+ every 20 days of teaching. $40,000, believe that. But your $300 will help me on stay on television. That's the whole thing about offerings. And, of course, to pay a staff is more. That's a whole other thing, to pay a staff to orchestrate your world ministry. You have to have money to fulfill your assignment. Get over the fact that you have to have it. Just accept that. Must be a good thing because it's a divine reward for being productive. Money is a reward system. Let's see if I can hold this up. Money is a reward system. Let me give you the steps to take, because there would be 1,000, in the name of Jesus, I decree it so, there will be 1,000 proteges that listen to me, and I hope you apply at least some of it, if not all of it. The number one thing in my life is the Holy Spirit, the invisible Jesus who walks on my right side. He's my life. He's my confidant. He's my advisor. I pray in the Spirit a whole lot. Not enough. My mind gets off on too many things, but I pray in the Holy, in my prayer language a whole lot. Some preachers believe you shouldn't do it around other people, and they probably have a scripture for that. I know the scripture they use, but I don't. I pray in the Holy Ghost a whole lot, and my attention is more on the Holy Spirit than people around me. I don't mind being misunderstood by people as long as I'm understood by the Holy Spirit. He knows me very well. He knows my passion to please him. I ask him today to show me how to restrain myself and keep myself because I'm very militant. My passion can get off track. One of my weaknesses, I love people so much that when I see them off track, I get involved. And I love right so much in righteousness that when people are liars or they try to hurt my people, like last night, the neighborhood that I'm in, they all came out there. The head of the HOA said, you're not a part of our neighborhood and you cannot be using this road. I have it's a crazy, crazy way, crazy thing that happened last night. And of course I would go to the law. I always follow the law. Let me just mention this too. Follow the law, just follow the law. I feel like if I follow the law, and of course, if it's a law against God's law, that would be different. If the law said go murder somebody, I wouldn't do that because I follow God's law. God's law first, and earthly law, what do they call it? All the laws here on the earth, I follow that. That's second to God's law. But I've never seen an earthly law that was against God's law here in the United States. I can't say I've ever seen that. Maybe there was during, segregation. I have the horrible memories of seeing a water fountain that says for coloreds and one said for whites. I thought, that's insane. That's not even unscriptural. It's just insane. Insane. Racism is insane. And by the way, I wouldn't vote for a politician ever. I don't care who he was. I don't care if his name was Jesus Jr. I wouldn't vote for a politician who was racist. Racism is dumb. It's just deeply, deeply satanic. Deeply satanic. How'd I get off on that? until I bounce it off the wall here a second. Let me get weight. To prosper, you need to know that you need to be persuaded that you have something that's very valuable to somebody. I think I'm very valuable to somebody. I'm very valuable to somebody who needs someone to tell the truth. I hate lying. I don't lie. And it's something that I'm trying to think right now if I've ever lied since I was 10 years old. I don't remember ever lying since I was 10 years old. Surely I have. Somewhere I've slipped up. But I wouldn't do it purposely if I misstated something. I am persuaded that telling the truth gets favor from God. And favor from God means favor with men. I would be very honest with my boss. I'd be very honest in your business. If you have a business, I'd sure love to give you ideas because here's another key to 20% increase. Know how God uses you. Know how God uses you. I'm not slick. I hear slick. I know slick when I hear it. I know slick when I hear it. I know slither when I hear it. I know when somebody's trying to trick me up. I know when somebody's trying to slide something past me. I know when people avoid my questions and they slip around me and try to go around me. I see that every day of my life. It affects me and I wish it didn't. Know how God uses you. Like I've made up my mind now. I'm 70. My focus, I get invited to a lot. We'll probably have a 500,000 plus in my services there because they run 300,000 on Sunday morning in the church in Lagos, 300,000, believe it or not. Crowds are wonderful because at least there's a portion of them that will listen. But I'm not a crowd guy. I don't have to have, I'm not, I hate to use that word, get off. I don't look for crowds. I look for hunger. I look for people with needs who will listen. That's probably my little mantra there. Someone who hurts who will listen to me because I can stop pain. I know how to stop pain because I've had so much of it, I've had to stop it. I believe I know how to generate finances in any business. I've helped business just flourishes. One man, I so revolutionized his business. If I called his name, you'd know the man because he's very famous in America. He was going bankrupt, changed his whole life with 2 hours. 2 hours. This is why I feel like I'm going to address you as protege 1000. A protege is someone willing to listen to someone with a difference. I want to come back to the word mentorship. Thank you for writing all your notes here. Thank you for writing all your notes, and I'll come back and read them. I promise I will read every note that you send me on Periscope today. I promise I will come back and read every single note that you write me here. Do forgive me for not looking at them anymore because I won't be able to teach. I won't be able to teach if I stop to read them, okay, right now. But if know this, if I tell you I read them, I read them. I do what I say because it's easier. I don't want a conscience that's bothered. I'm a man who cannot live with something wrong. I can't live with something wrong around me. I can't live with something wrong in me. I'm not my best. I'm not my best. I found that out at a young age that I am my best when I'm straightforward. I am my best in meaning I don't clog up. If I have to be calculating in my speech, if I have to be very, very, very careful because somebody's going to grab one, you know, media will grab three words out of a sentence and quote you. I found this out years ago that they would ask me a question, I give them an answer, but they wouldn't attach my answer to the question. They would use a different question, and the quote would be right, but it wasn't my wasn't my words to their question. I don't think I've ever met a newspaper reporter who would agree to quote all of my answers. In fact, they won't. They wouldn't. And that's why I stopped talking to newspapers reporters, because they wouldn't. And every politician knows that. That's why they have to be careful. They really do have to be careful. Politicians have to be very meticulous. Mr. Trump is not calculating. He's a fast thinker. He's a smart man. Very lovable person. Has many parts to him. And depending on the people that's talking to him, if he's around an enemy, he acts very different than when he's comfortable around people who believe in him. I've seen him with friends. I've seen him with enemies. And like all of us, he acts very different because of the environment. Jesus was different when he's holding a baby on his lap, different than when he used a whip and drove everybody out of the temple. Jesus did that. And God even recorded it in the Bible. So it must be there's a place for anger. There's a place for it. I wish I knew where to use it. But there is a place. there is a place for it. Let's get back to your 20% increase. Yesterday, I made a decision that I would focus on 1,000. I call it protege 1,000 instead of protege 300 or something like that. 300 is a good Bible number. But the Lord gave me the scripture today when I woke up about protege 1,000. I was trying to link the 1,000 to something in scripture. Solomon sacrificed 1,000. I think it was sheep or sacrifices, 1,000. And I broke the back of poverty with $1,000 seed. And let me tell you something. When I talk about seed sowing and getting into a relationship with God, I'm not limiting that to my ministry. Please don't ever think that. Please don't ever think that. You got a pastor that's been your pastor, served you, loved on you, come see you in the hospital. Oh, grab that man and make him your financial partner. I think a pastor is the most important person in your life. I really do. It's wonderful. I'm on television, but I feel like your pastor is far more important to you than Mike Murdoch. I want to say that again. Your pastor, the man who comes sees you in the hospital, the man who sits at your house and prays over your family, the man who's there on Thursday nights and Wednesday nights and Sunday. Now, a lot of people consider me their pastor, and I value that. I guess I am. But don't ever send money all around the world and not make your pastor the number one. That's what I feel. I feel like the pastor's more important than any missionary in your life. I just feel like a pastor, and I'm not really cut out to be one at all. But I just feel like that pastors are profound people, men and women. I just think pastors have something I don't have. They just have something I don't have. And I value it. Yes, I am a pastor. Yes, I do pastor the Wisdom Center as a senior pastor. Yes, I do have several pastors under me. But don't walk away from the people who are with you every day. Don't do that. Don't do that. Don't even send money to me. If you've neglected your pastor, put your pastor ahead of Mike Murdoch. Always, always put your pastor ahead of Mike Murdoch. I think you ought to know that. You need to know that. If you have $1,000 to sow, and you said every Sunday morning, every Sunday night, and you sat under a pastor 10, 15 years, and he's been the one there, how do I say this? If he doesn't believe in prosperity, you got a problem. You got a problem. But do love on him. Make love on him. And honor him. And honor is a financial thing. Back to my list of 20% increase. What I'm doing today is establishing 1,000 people I can track. In other words, your letters, all of those things, I want to be able to track your testimony. There's a young lady that just texted me this morning through Twitter and said I was a wicked young girl. She was an exotic dancer and heard me one night and said I forever changed her life. She'll never know what those words mean to me, because helping people is food to me. It's food to me. If I get a testimony, I can run for several days on one testimony. I can run if I know somebody listened to me. There is not one piece of doubt in me that I can revolutionize anybody's life for good. There's not a single doubt in me that I can unlock the financial link with you and God. I believe that everywhere I go, money begins to run freely. It turns from a drip, drip, drip to a river. And I know that. That's one of the ways God uses me. In fact, it's one of the ways I want him to use me.